Do you know, people, I've made many statements about being sober. And what I can really say is sobriety fucking sucks.
We interrupt this program to give you a bulletin just received from one of our naval units at sea. A large object traveling at supersonic speed is headed over the North Atlantic toward the east coast of the United States.
An unidentified object was picked up 200 miles southwest of Point Barrow, Alaska.
Shall we report it, sir?
What, that we're being invaded by little green men from outer space?
Flying saucers have invaded our planet.
It was a saucer. A flying saucer.
Nor to evidence these creatures have scientific knowledge far in advance of our own.
We've come to this planet looking for intelligent life. Oops, we made a mistake.
Welcome again to the podcast that each and every week showcases humans behaving badly. This is why the aliens don't come. My name is Brendan Millett, and with me as always is the bright-eyed and bushy-tailed Michelle Poitras.
Get at my right hand or get at him away.
I threw in that description for you as a throwback joke.
Oh, yeah. But
when I used to have to try to get you up in the morning, and I'm like, wake up, rise and shine, bright-eyed, bushy-tailed.
Uh-huh,
and you were like, fuck you.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Anyway, although now it's just been 20 years of fuck you.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah. We just see each other now, and you're like, dick, skank, whatever.
Yeah, pretty much.
Anyway, folks, thank you for joining us. If you're new to the podcast, welcome. Join our Facebook group. Find us on SoundCloud, the Crazed Weasel YouTube channel, and follow us on Twitter at...
TIWTADC.
I'm not on our Twitter much. I mean, here and there, but I am on mine a lot.
Yeah, I'm on mine. I should get back on ours.
I mean, when we like do a new episode, I'll tweet something. Or if I post something in the Facebook group, usually I'll tweet it.
Yeah, yeah.
Too.
Yeah.
I took a chance on that Green Lives Matter one.
I know.
I'm like, this is either going to be funny or somebody's going to get pissed. Somehow nobody got pissed.
Yeah, yeah.
I was like, okay, good, because it was supposed to be funny.
It is funny.
Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Didn't get crickets or get my ass kicked for anything.
No. Okay, so trying to get here to do this.
Uh-huh.
Someone randomly decided that on the main road that crosses with my street, they're going to do tree work. And that's a windy road. So you can't always see around the bends. So the tree workers are taking up an entire chunk. They're taking up the whole lane.
Yeah, as they often do.
Which you have to go around them. So they very thoughtfully put up workers ahead signs 10 feet from where they're working.
Thanks for the tip.
You're supposed to put those like a quarter of a mile out so that people know. Especially when you're blocking half the street.
Yeah, you don't put men working right where the men are working.
Right.
No.
No, you don't do that.
Gonna have a bad time.
And there was no one directing traffic.
Really?
Yeah, no.
No cop, nobody in an orange vest,
When I came back later, one of the workers was standing on the opposite side of the road, kind of watching, but he wasn't, like, directing anything.
Really?
Yeah.
I've only seen that one time, and that was a couple months ago when the girlfriend and I were staying at a place up in Maine, very remote, very small town.
Yeah.
And they took up half the road, and there was nobody directing traffic, but here's the thing. That road sees, what, 3-4 cars a day? That's fine.
Yeah, the roads around me are a little busier than that.
Yeah, because we're an actual civilization here.
Uh-huh. So, yeah.
Aren't they, like, legally required to have something like that?
You would think so. Yeah.
Peoples.
Mm-hmm. Peoples.
Peoples.
Yeah.
That's why the aliens don't come. And that's why we're here.
Yeah. Well, largely because we don't put out any warning signs saying, like, idiocy here, stay away.
Come on! That sign shouldn't have been on the moon! It should have been 3 solar systems ago, so we know to avoid it!
Pretty much! Pretty much!
Yeah.
I really do think the ones that get here are like, oh my god, fuck these guys.
Speaking of stuff like that, this is just an idea I've been kicking around.
All right.
Since we have this, you know, this theme, this gimmick, if you will, that everything on this show is reasons the aliens don't come, for all of that, we don't do a lot of stuff about actual aliens.
Mm.
So I thought, not this week, not even next week, but maybe sometime in the near future.
Maybe not today, maybe not tomorrow, but someday and for the rest of your life.
God damn it. That we should do something, some kind of stupid UFO stories. Like maybe abduction, like really fucked up abduction stories, or like, you know, like really detailed, silly abduction stories.
I feel like we tried that and it didn't really flow.
Did we? Yeah. I don't remember. I don't think we did.
I don't know. I feel like we tried that and it just didn't really, recall. There wasn't enough material.
I'll go back through the podcast, but I don't know if we ever did.
I thought we did.
No, we did a few things that didn't really take off, but
yeah, I thought that was
like we only did that Kevin Bacon thing like once.
Yeah.
Because I just realized this is not good radio.
No, it's not.
No, it was a cute song that I found on YouTube, so I wanted to use it.
Of course.
That Kevin Bacon want bacon, you know?
Right, yes.
Yeah, that was good.
Sure.
But this one did stick, and that's why, of all the segments we do, this is the one we do each and every week. It's called Headlines.
I said the headlines, headlines, have you heard it? Headlines, headlines, hit it.
Remember how last week I said we had the best headlines ever?
Uh-huh.
I spoke too soon.
I knew it.
I spoke way too soon, because these are gems, too.
Oh, boy.
I don't know where I keep finding them.
I don't either.
But I'm pulling them out of somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this one.
Yeah.
Okay, you remember the one about the guy who drove his dead grandmother around the nudist colony naked for like 5 hours? Remember that?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay, this is another grandma one that I don't get.
What is it up with people like messing with their grandmas?
I don't know. But somebody messed with someone else's grandma on this one.
Oh, no. You don't mess with someone else's grandma.
This one reads, "Grandma stolen, later recovered." Don't steal my grandma.
How do you steal a grandma? Isn't that kidnapping?
Well, yeah. But
unless she's dead.
I mean, I might go see a band called Stolen Grandma.
Yeah.
Because that'd be a good band name, but yeah. Who steals a grandma and why?
Stealing Grandma.
Now that's a movie title.
Yeah.
Stealing Grandma, Raising Arizona, Chasing Amy.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? Yeah. Grandma stolen later. Well, at least they got her back.
I guess. I mean, did they, like, steal her ashes? Like, was it that kind of stealing?
That's an excellent question. Did they physically steal, like, a living person? Or did they steal, like, an urn?
Yeah, I don't know.
Yeah. Well, my grandmas have been gone a long time, so I don't really think anybody's stealing them.
Yeah, mine are both gone, too.
Mine actually went within a year of each other.
Huh.
Yeah. All right. So this
well, that's
one.
That's morbid.
Yeah, a little bit. Comedy, everybody! Let's move on from dead grandmas.
Please.
To something that this one gets shit done.
Okay.
This is right up your alley.
All right, let's hear it.
Naked man hospitalized after drinking game leads to prosthetic leg being set aflame.
That's kind of amazing. I want to go to that party. That sounds like a really good party.
It does. It's not a good party unless someone's prosthetic limb gets set on fire. That's what I've always said.
I know. Yeah.
How do you even do that? It's not like they're actually made of wood anymore.
Maybe
aren't they made out of like fiberglass or something? Can you set fiberglass on fire?
I don't know. It would smell terrible.
Yeah.
Maybe he did have an old fashioned wooden one. Who knows?
Maybe.
How old is the story? How old's the guy? I mean, we don't.
Fuck if I know. This is headlines, not CNN. I'm sorry. I don't have any details.
But that's my point. We have a lot of unknowns here.
That's kind of part of the bit.
I know.
50-something episodes in.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, just saying.
And I'm sort of shining a light on that.
Although sometimes, as you know, I would like to have some of them splained.
Splained.
But our anonymous source is off this week, so yeah, I don't think we're going to get splanations today.
Yeah, true. But yeah, I would love to be at that party where the prosthetic leg gets set on fire. That sounds like...
Was it on him at the time?
I know. Did someone take it off and like,
light it on fire? Or did it... I'm picturing some dude with a fake leg with it on fire and like literally kicking the leg off, you know?
Oh no, I'm picturing somebody like dancing around with the wooden leg in their hand and then like, you know, just like, woo! Like, and then it's on fire.
Oh, shit. No, that sounds like a good party.
Using it as like a caveman torch or something. I don't know.
Oh my God. Now this next one. Oh my God, I can't believe somebody said this in this day and age, in 2016.
Uh-oh.
This is so wrong.
Okay.
The headline reads, disclaimer, I'm only reading a headline. Being bullied? Just act less gay, advise teachers.
No!
Somebody said this. If you're being bullied, act less gay. Gay.
No, no. In fact, you know what you do? Act more gay. Act as gay as you possibly fucking can. Walk around with a dildo in your ass. Do it, man.
Clean it up.
Seriously. Just put it right in their faces. They're not going to touch you.
Well, they might. But who's... Oh, my God. Like, unless this headline is from a much less enlightened time.
No, I really think some old-ass teacher probably said to their student, and that's probably why.
Yeah, we'll stop acting like a bunch of queers.
Yeah, well, totally. Or something like that. And that's probably why it's a headline, because it probably caused an uproar.
Yeah, probably, as well it should.
Uh-huh.
Little bit.
No. Get your pink sparklies out. Get your heart-shaped sunglasses out. Seriously, women shave your heads. Like, dike it up.
Leave Elton John in the dust.
Seriously, no. And women, get as militant as you can with the camo pants and shave your heads and, like, no. We
play up the stereotypes.
Just play up all the stereotypes you possibly can. Oh, just fucking do it, man.
Just to piss these ignorant fucks off.
Seriously.
Oh, my God. Can you believe somebody would even say that in this day and age?
Oh, my God, no.
Oh, my God.
Like, yes, but no. But yes.
But there are other, you know, more positive aspects about the age we live in. One in particular is...
Wait a minute, there's something better to do than gay it up?
Yes.
Okay.
Medical marijuana. And that's what this next headline is about.
All right, I'm just going to go ahead and disagree with you on that.
No. Trust me, you're going to enjoy this headline, because it involves something that everybody likes.
Doritos?
Believe it or not, no. Medical marijuana delivery man attacked by ninjas.
Fantastic. Fantastic.
Those ninjas wanted to get high, apparently.
Or they were trying to stop other people from damaging their bodies and doing drugs.
I know you and I have a different positions on the use of medical marijuana. But I'm just saying... Anytime anybody is attacked by ninjas, it's somehow awesome.
The story automatically gets cooler.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
I mean, I used to date a girl who had a t-shirt that said ninjas are cool. And by cool, I mean totally sweet.
Oh, yeah, totally.
Anything is better with ninjas.
There's actually a t-shirt that's like, there are 500 ninjas on this t-shirt. Good luck trying to find them.
I need that in my life. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. But yeah, why did the ninjas attack the medical marijuana man?
They probably just wanted stash.
That sounded like a superhero. Medical marijuana man!
Oh, no.
Yeah. He always forgets where the crimes are being committed, so he can't stop them.
Yeah, totally.
Keeping Doritos and Twinkies safe. In his belly. Well, there was that old George Carlin joke where he said one of the problems that marijuana is having in being decriminalized, nobody can remember where they left the petitions.
Yeah.
I think I had three.
Yeah, I had three. What are we talking about?
Oh, the petitions, right.
Yeah. Reasons marijuana will never be legal.
Now, there's a band name in this next one, if there ever was one.
Mm-hmm.
But I still would like to know how this works. Judging by the font, I'm guessing this is in one of those, like, Weekly World News type of tabloids.
Oh, so like, it's not like... Like the Inquirer or kind like of, Us Weekly.
Because it reads, Devil Otter Ate My Minivan. Now, I've heard about dingoes eating people's babies, but never a devil otter... Eating, first of all, how does an otter eat something many times larger than itself?
Well, that's what the constrictors do. They just, like, unhinge their jaw and, like, they have, like, a whole sheep inside
them.
Yeah,
but the problem is that then you're going to get an otter the size of a minivan. And I don't want that.
Well, just because you don't want it doesn't mean it can't happen.
Well, it should, damn it.
I'm sorry, the world doesn't work that way.
But we'd all go see a band called Devil Otter.
I would go see a minivan otter and devil otter.
Oh, yeah. Underneath the headline, for some reason, it says farmer attacked by fur bag.
Was it the minivan otter?
Yes, I guess. Yes. The devil otter ate the minivan and then went for the farmer.
It needed dessert. No, no. Still hungry.
I'm going to need a farmer to wash down this minivan, said no one ever. Want a beverage?
Maybe a Colt 22 while I'm at it.
Oh, God. And finally this week, technically not a headline, but you notice a few times I've snuck in some police log stuff.
Sure.
Most epic police log ever.
Okay.
I don't get it. I don't need to get it. It's just awesome on its own.
You just let it wash over you. You don't need to understand.
Basking in the glory.
Yes.
3:56 p.m. Dispatch report of Swanson Chicken Pot Pie running east on Clay Street.
I want to live in that world.
How did they print this? With a straight face.
I don't know.
Who reported? Okay, I'm just going to say this. If I am a 911 dispatcher and somebody calls me to report a Swanson chicken pot pie running at all, let alone down east on Clay Street, I'm sending the cops to their house because they are fucked up on something that is not legal.
Probably. But first you have to stop laughing and recover long
there
enough
is that.
To actually report him.
There is that.
Yeah.
Because Swanson chicken pot pies in their natural state tend not to run much.
Food does not talk.
Food does not run.
Yeah.
Well, some food runs when it's still alive, you know, a chicken.
Well, yeah.
You know, maybe. You know.
Yeah, totally. Yeah, if it was actually like just a chicken.
Well, yeah. But this is a chicken pot
but
pie.
But not chicken pot pie.
A chicken, that's just a potential pot pie.
Yeah, exactly.
This is an actual pot pie.
Yeah, no, we're not down with that.
I'd be doing the Cartman voice. It's my pot pie.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah, kitty, my pot pie.
Speaking of chickens and like it being a potential pot pie, somebody was just telling me that somewhere, I forget where, there is a restaurant where you can actually pick out your own chicken. Living chicken.
Yeah.
And they will kill it and cook it for you.
Huh.
I talk about reminding yourself where you are on the food chain.
Yeah, really.
That's a bit much.
That's a lot, yeah.
That'd be like going to a pasture and picking out a cow. But then again, you can eat a whole chicken. Yeah. I have yet to meet a human being who can eat a whole cow.
Yeah, that's a lot. It's a lot this big.
A little bit. That'd be a little nuts.
Then you end up with cow-sized humans.
As opposed to minivan-sized otters.
Yes.
Oh, that's the fucking world we live in. Crazy peoples.
Yeah, totally.
Speaking of which, we talk about them too on this show. We used to talk about just crazy dating stories and crazy exes, but just decided to expand it into just general crazy people. We call this, of course, Too Bad You're Crazy.
Too bad you're crazy. Too bad you're loony as hell. So long, it could have been swell together.
There's a lot of insanity in this world. There just is.
Well, yeah.
I don't get it. I think people are just getting crazier and crazier and crazier.
No,
crazy
no.
is going to be the, I think within the next 20 years, crazy will be the new normal.
I don't think we're getting crazier. I think we're just uncovering more crazy that already existed.
Yeah, perhaps. Maybe with the rise of the internet and technology, we're just seeing more
crazy. We're seeing it more. Absolutely.
We're not able to hide it as well.
Yeah, exactly.
So we shall begin the craziness. You've been to Disney, right?
Once.
Did you go on Space Mountain?
No.
No, really?
I hate roller coasters.
I hate roller coasters too, but I went on Space Mountain.
My sister tried to trick me into going on Space Mountain and I threw a fucking tantrum and said no.
Wow. Guys, I just figured if you go to Disney, you gotta go on Space Mountain.
Absolutely
so
not.
I just, you know, held on and bore it.
No,
you know?
She tried to trick me into, she tried to tell me it was like Epcot, that it was like a like one of the slow rides.
No,
and
it's
then,
not.
Yeah, and then,
it's a roller coaster in the fucking dark.
Yeah, no.
Yeah.
I would not go on it with her.
Yeah, and unfortunately that did not help me because my eyes quickly adjusted to the dark and I could see everything.
Yeah,
so that was no fun. But this takes place at Space Mountain.
Okay.
So this person says, this couple was trying to ride Space Mountain and had a black duffel bag. I heard something come from the bag, so I asked them to open it. They refused. Security comes, forces them to open it. It was their six-month-old baby.
No!
Someone tried to smuggle their six-month-old baby onto Space Mountain.
No.
In a duffel bag.
No!
Party foul.
Off my planet.
Bye-bye. Leave the baby. Get off my planet.
Yeah, totally. The baby still has a shot. You guys are fucked.
Yeah. Wow, that almost sounded like leave the gun, take the cannolis. Leave the baby, take the crazy people.
I know, seriously.
Oh, my God. I know that we talk about, you know, Florida being sort of a craziness hellmouth. Well, some crazy shit happens in New York, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of like this one. I was on the subway in Manhattan on the L train. It was about 2 a.m., and this guy got on the train wrapped up in aluminum foil.
Oh, boy.
He constructed what was meant to be a spacesuit. He was also wearing aluminum foil antennas on his head. He asked for everyone's attention and said that he was an alien from a different planet. Oh, I guess they came. And he was trying to find his way home. He also said that his spaceship had crashed somewhere over in Brooklyn and he's lost. He was playing an instrument that resembled a trumpet and said that this was his space language. He was quite serious.
I think the aliens need to eradicate him for impersonating them.
Yeah, they should show up just to say, this man does not represent us.
Mm-hmm.
Klaatu's pissed.
Yeah, really.
We haven't talked about Klaatu in a while.
No, we have not.
He's kind of like our official mascot.
Huh.
The alien in our logo, Klaatu, that's his name.
Yeah, really.
Which, for super duper nerds is from The Day the Earth Stood Still, the original.
Ah.
Because the words to power on the robot were Klaatu, Virata, Niktu, which were then appropriated for Army of Darkness.
Right.
Lengthy explanation. But anyway, moving right along with the insanity.
Mm-hmm.
A 15-year-old boy was lying on a stretcher with his mother sitting next to him. The boy was coming down from methamphetamine, not a good time, that he had injected into his veins with needles he had been sharing with his friends.
No!
Concerned about this, the doctor asked the boy if there was anything he might have been doing to put him at risk for AIDS. The boy thought for a while and then said questioningly, "I've been screwing the dog."
Oh no!
There is too much wrong happening in this story. You're doing meth, you're shooting it up, you're sharing needles, and screwing the pooch.
Oh no.
Damn shame what they did to that dog.
Oh no.
You okay?
I'm...
You gonna make it?
I'm kind of horrified.
Well, yeah, I would hope so. If you weren't, I'd say get out of here.
Yeah. I'm not usually in favor of the death penalty, but I don't know if there's any hope left for that one.
No, I think he's pretty much done.
Mm.
But not sharing needles putting him at risk for AIDS. Fucking the dog, apparently.
And honestly...
Is there canine HIV? Is that a thing?
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
Not that I know of.
But
honestly, he's now officially an animal abuser, and I'm like, put him down.
Pull the plug. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well, you know, you work in the medical field. I'm sure you see all kinds of crazy shit. Mm-hmm. Just be thankful you don't work in an ER.
Yeah.
Like this next story that takes place in an ER. One morning, an ER received a call from a cheerful lady. When asked what could be done for her, she answered that she'd like the number to the local radio station. Upon being told she had called the hospital emergency room, she replies, "I know that. I need it right away."
Oh, God.
It doesn't work that way.
No, it doesn't. No.
That'd be like calling information and asking what the capital of Zimbabwe is. It's not that kind of information.
Not that kind of information.
Not that kind of an emergency, lady.
No, sorry. Try again.
Yeah. Not how this works. Not any of this works.
No. This is for actual, like, medical emergencies.
Yes.
Bitch.
You sounded kind of Valley Girl there for a second. This is for actual emergencies, bitch. And final craziness this week.
Uh-huh.
An Ask a Nurse line at a small town hospital received a call from a very upset woman who couldn't stop crying. After several minutes of the call, the nurse trying to calm her, it was discovered that the woman thought she had been exposed to anthrax upon opening a letter. She had opened an email.
Oh no.
A broken brain. Not working. Cannot lower intellect to such a level. Also not how this works.
No, wrong kind of virus, honey.
Yeah, and wrong kind of mail, more like it.
That too.
My God. When was the last time somebody even did something like that, put anthrax in the mail? It was like 15 years ago.
Something like that.
That was like very soon after 9/11. I don't think anybody's done it since.
I don't think so. Ridiculous.
Okay. After all that, especially the meth addict screwing the pooch, we need to cleanse the palate.
Yeah, please.
With the craziness hellmouth. That is the source of Michelle's favorite segment. We call it, of course, Fun with Florida. Look, up in the sky. It's a bird. It's a plane. It's Florida Man! And he is the star of our first two Florida stories this week. This one... Okay, fine. This is just awesome enough to... I would describe it as epic. Just because there were bladed weapons involved.
Okay.
Florida man attacks mom's boyfriend with samurai sword over missing can of shrimp. Welcome back to Proportional Response. I'm your host, Brendan Millett. So yeah, somebody went all Duncan MacLeod of the Clan MacLeod. Yeah, Highlander reference, deal with it. Over a missing can of shrimp.
Missing shrimp.
Shrimp sandwich. Shrimp gumbo. You look like you're pondering.
I'm trying to...
Pinky, are you pondering what I'm pondering?
I think so, Brain, but where are we going to find a duck in a hose at this hour?
You'd be surprised.
I'm trying to imagine...
Picture, if you will.
how good this shrimp must be. For it to be worth killing a man.
And is there not, was that it? There isn't any more shrimp around? Or is that why you went for the sword? Because there could be only one. That was a deliberate cricket joke. I did that one on purpose just for the look on your face. You were saying.
This must be some fucking amazing shrimp.
2 years from now, I want to say, did you have the shrimp?
The shrimp, yeah.
But Florida Man, of course, does not stop there. Because Florida Man attacks three women with a sword and a peanut butter sandwich.
For the shrimp.
I guess the peanut butter sandwich was his backup weapon.
Or he couldn't find the shrimp, so he just had a peanut butter sandwich instead. I guess he really didn't want the shrimp that bad in the first place. But he attacked three women with a sword and a peanut butter
sandwich. And a peanut butter sandwich. Now, I get how somebody attacks one with a sword.
Okay, but
that's what a sword is designed for. But how do you attack somebody with something that cannot possibly cause you injury unless you have a peanut allergy?
I mean, maybe they meant he attacked them with a sword while eating the sandwich.
No, it says attacked three women with a sword and peanut butter sandwich. So he's like, sword in one hand, sandwich in the other. Wah! Like a peanut butter ninja.
You know, life on crack must be really interesting.
Yeah, I think so.
Maybe he thought, like I said, maybe he thought they stole his shrimp. And in order to tide him over for the battle, he needed the peanut butter sandwich.
He needed the peanut butter sandwich for energy for the sword combat so he could get his shrimp back.
I know.
Oh, God, fucking Florida. What is wrong with you people? Oh. So, this one, okay, have you ever known a crazy cat lady?
I think so.
I sort of know a crazy cat lady. I wouldn't say she's crazy, but she's a little bit older than me, and she has like 5 or 6 cats. Uh-huh. It's freaking ridiculous. Going to her house was fun, let me tell you, considering I'm allergic to the damn things.
Of course.
But this involves somebody with a number of cats.
Okay.
James Lawler, cat food, quote, hustler, says he steals chow for friend with 300 cats.
That's called an animal hoarder. And that is, like, cause to call, like, animal control services.
Where do you keep 300 cats?
Watch Hoarders sometime. You'll find out.
I watched it once. I'm all set.
Well, that's where they end up.
I saw one where their house was so bad, they, like, had to have guys go in with hazmat suits to get stuff out.
Yeah, that's where the animals end up.
This person had all kinds of health problems because they were basically living in a cesspool of bacteria and whatever.
Well, that's where 300 cats end up. They end up, dead in the walls. They end up rotting under piles of, like, clothes and garbage. They end up, you know, with like, one eye and, like, the fur falling out. Like, it's not good.
To quote Han Solo, what an amazing smell you've discovered.
Yeah, 300 cats, half of them are dead. I'm just going to guarantee that right now. And that place smells like, the things George Carlin would talk about that I probably shouldn't say because they're horribly politically incorrect.
Oh, yeah.
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 All of that. Together. All of that. Together.
That thing I won't say, that.
All of it together.
Now, okay, we've done many stories on this show about people, and we just did one, about misusing 911.
Oh, no.
Yeah. This is not a reason to call 911. I can understand you maybe taking this as a personal affront, but it is unfortunately not a crime.
Yeah.
Fort Pierce man to 911. My neighbors won't drink with me.
Oh!
I feel bad for you, but if you're willing to call 911 over that shit, I think we may have pinpointed the reason.
Oh.
Because you're probably batshit.
Probably a little needy.
And a little cray-cray if you're calling 911 because somebody won't have a beer with you.
Yeah.
It may be taken as a personal slight, but it's hardly an emergency, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Probably the craziest misuse of 911, which also I'm pretty sure happened in Florida. Mm-hmm. And I think we've talked about this before. A woman called 911 because there was a crazy glowing yellow ball in the sky and she was convinced it was aliens coming to attack us.
It was the sun, wasn't it?
It was the sun. Yeah.
Oh, God. That... God, I can't. There's a glowing yellow ball in the sky, and it's the sun.
And you live in Florida. You see it every day.
A lot.
A lot.
They get a lot of sun there.
They do. Probably a little too much.
I think Florida is like a million miles closer to the sun than New England.
And she was convinced it was attacking her because she stared at it for 10 minutes and then her eyes hurt.
Booyah!
That's called permanent, like, retinal damage.
I'd like to give them some permanent rectal damage by kicking their ass.
Okay, I'm glad you clarified that.
Ew. Really? You had to take it there. You had to make it weird. You had to make it a butt sex joke, didn't you?
I've been dating boy too long.
I guess so. Oh, that's true. What is his obsession with anal jokes? Why do you think I've been questioning the man's sexuality for the last decade and a half?
I can assure you he's straight.
I'm just saying. Hey, Elton John used to be married to a woman too. That's all I'm saying.
I mean, although one could question how straight he is considering he fucks me. Anyway.
Okay, I could take this to a really inappropriate place, but I won't. Anyway, moving right along. And finally, this week, in the epic adventures of our favorite superhero,
Florida Man.
This time, I guess he forgot his costume at home. Naked Florida Man jumps off roof onto man, knocks television over. By the way, Knox is spelt N-O-C-K-S. Knocks television over, empties vacuum cleaner, masturbates. No headline has ever gotten more shit done than that. He's naked, jumping off a roof onto somebody, knocking a television over, spelling it wrong, emptying the vacuum cleaner, and jerking off.
Life on meth must be great.
This might be like some sort of like a bath salts meth cocktail.
Yeah, maybe.
You know, with just a little pinch of crack.
Yeah,
some nice cream fraiche, you know? I just realized I sounded like I was on a drugs cooking show. Nice cream like I was like the Martha Stewart of cocaine products or whatever the fuck. Yes, but he jumps off a roof onto somebody, knocks a television over, empties a vacuum cleaner, and masturbates. How do you do all that at once? How many limbs does this guy have?
Maybe the other dude helped him.
Okay, all right, I guess you could jump off the roof, which the way you land, you could land on the guy.
And then be like,
you both bump
me!
Into the television.
Yeah.
You fall on the vacuum cleaner, it spills out everywhere, and the whole experience is so arousing for you, you just have to rub one out right there and then and there.
You could.
That's about the only way that headline works in the real world.
Unless he jumped off the roof last.
You know, if I did all that, I'd probably jump off a roof too.
Probably. Especially if you found yourself doing all of that naked.
Mm-hmm.
You'd be like, what the fuck even is my life?
How the mighty have fallen. Anyway, folks, thank you for joining us this week. As I said at the top of the show, find us on SoundCloud, YouTube, join our Facebook group, and follow us on Twitter at
TIWTADC.
Naked roof jumpers, knocking over TVs, emptying the vacuum cleaner while rubbing one out. Definitely a big reason the aliens
don't come.
This podcast is the property of Brendan Millett, all rights reserved. All music and audio clips used in this podcast are the property of their respective copyright owners. This podcast was hosted by Brendan Millett and Michelle Poitras. Opening theme composed and performed by Chris Lott. Official logo by Michael Magario at Pixel Pusher Studio. If you've enjoyed this podcast, join our Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/thisiswhythealiensdon'tcome, all one word.